Hey guys, Rusty over here, and today I'm going to be showing you how you can solo Operation Mechagon Hard Mode for the 100% drop chance of the Aerial Unit R-21X mount, which, by the way, those little balls on it, well, they look just like that. Balls. Anyways, two things we need to go over first before I get into the actual guide. The first one being, and this is the important one, guys, not all classes are going to be able to do this, mainly due to the fourth boss, the Aerial Oppression Unit. I will leave the timestamp in the video below if you want to skip ahead and see why, but right now only high mobility classes are going to be able to solo this. The second one being item level, you do not need to be super geared to do this. I did this around, I think, 221 or 222 item level. With the Heart of Azeroth equipped, since it works in BFA, I did around 217, right? But you could probably do this around 205 to 210 item level, especially if you're using the Heart of Azeroth necklace with the Azerite essences. But obviously more item level always helps. So with that being said, let's get into the guide. So first things first, you need to actually head over to the island of Mechagon where the dungeon is located, which, by the way, if you don't actually have the island unlocked through the quest line, you could simply fly there from Stormsong Valley. Didn't know that until today. Anyways, fly there if you don't have the place unlocked and set the dungeon difficulty to Mythic. It has to be on Mythic, and then you can head on in. Now, to trigger the hard mode of Operation Mechagon, you need to kill the first three bosses in a certain order. Now, the way you see which order to kill the first three bosses in is to look up in the sky and see where the Aerial Oppression Unit is flying. Also, if you open your map, there'll be a little dot with wings. If you hover your mouse over it, it'll say Aerial Oppression Unit, and you can see where it's located. So, for example, for me, when I first entered the dungeon, the Aerial Oppression Unit was flying over the middle bosses, which are the two gnome bosses. So, I would head over there first and kill that boss first, and then it'll fly to one of the other bosses. I would kill that boss second. It'll go fly over to the last boss, kill that boss third, and then finally the fourth boss, you kill him last. Now, while you're fighting the boss, if you're fighting the boss while the Aerial Oppression Unit is under, he's going to do two things. The big one is going to be the three robot adds he spawns. They are going to fixate you and just slowly walk towards you. If you stand in the circle, they might sometimes stun you. Since you're doing this at 60 though, they might miss sometimes. And also to put pools on the ground, which do damage to you and slow you. So kite them as best as you can. They don't do crazy damage, but obviously try not to stand in them if you're taking a large amount of damage. Pretty obvious. Wow, 101. Besides that, we'll just put a swirly on the ground. Try not to stand in it. Easy enough. Basic World of Warcraft 101. Now, before we move on, I figured I should mention the buff bots around the first half of the dungeon that you can click on. Now, the grease bot will give you movement speed and a haste buff. The welding bot will increase your healing and increase your maximum health. And then you also have the shock bot, which gives your attacks to do extra damage, which is actually a decent chunk of damage. So if you see these bots around the dungeon, definitely make sure to equip them. They will make your run much easier. So once again, the first boss that the Aerial Oppression Unit was above for me were Trixie and Nano, the two gnome bosses in the middle. Now, the dude gnome boss will get in his motorcycle and charge you. Just try and avoid it. If it hits you, it's not the end of the world, though. And Trixie will pretty much just spam cast Tase and also Mega Tase. Don't worry about it. The only thing you really need to know, guys, is just don't tank them in the smoke, and you can kill them off. As again, you're doing this at 60, so most of the abilities won't even hit you, especially if you're doing this at a decent item level. The only hard part is really just avoiding the bots that the Aerial Oppression Unit is spawning in. Simple enough. Now, the second boss that the Aerial Oppression Unit moved to for me was King Gabamak, the Trog boss. Now, this one, if you're doing this at a very low item level, can be a little tricky. The reason for that is the abundant amount of Trog adds that will spawn on top of the robot adds that you're already hitting you. Now, the way you get rid of these is that you would get hit by Charge Smash and activate one of the coils, and it'll just kill the Trogs for you. But again, since you're doing this at 60, sometimes the Charge Smash will not hit you. Now, if you get lucky and it does, just stand by the coils, and that'll take care of most of the Trogs for you. If it doesn't, guys, completely ignore the adds. Put all your damage on the boss. It's not too difficult, but if you take too long to kill this boss, it can get a little out of hand, and you might get so many Trog adds to the point where they just kill you. Besides that, just kill the boss, avoid the swirlies on the ground, and once again, from the Aerial Oppression Unit, avoid the robots as best as you can. Now, once you kill the second boss, you could obviously move to the third and final boss that the Aerial Oppression Unit will move to, which for me was Gunker the Slime Boss. Now, if you're not sure how to spawn Gunker, you have to kill the three toxic monstrosities around the trash where he spawns. Kill those, it'll spawn the water bots that will go and spawn the boss. I do also recommend you clear the trash around the boss so you don't accidentally pull them while you're fighting him and they don't stick their finger up your butt. Now, once you actually pull the boss, he's not too difficult. You're gonna have the water bots going around him. always try and follow one of the water bots, as if you stand in the green slimes, you will be gooped, or basically you will be permanently stunned, and then since you're soloing this, you're pretty much dead if you get gooped, right? The water bots will clear the slime around the room. They'll also help you avoid coalesce, which sucks in all green pools around the room, and also toxic wave, which shoots out green pools. So essentially, follow the water bot as best as you can. Just watch out for the aerial oppression unit bots. The only other thing to mention is that the robots can get glooped. If the one you're following does get glooped, kill the gloop off so you can free the bot, and then you can go ahead and kill Gunker off. He's not too difficult of a boss. So again, follow the water bots around, free them if they get glooped, kill the boss. Simple enough. Next, we are going to move on to the fourth boss, which is the aerial oppression unit itself. And guys, everything about the hard mode is actually pretty easy, except this boss, which will whip out its 20-foot baby maker and just knock you out of the dungeon with it. This boss is very difficult. Only the high mobility classes are going to be able to do this. I'm telling you right now, the same thing I said at the beginning of the video. Most classes cannot do this boss, so you're probably going to need an alt that is high mobility with decent item level. So, the first things first, you have to kill the tank buster ad, which don't worry too much about that. It might just put a fulminating blast on you if you're unlucky, but you'll just take a burst of damage, not that much. It'll also spawn the walkie-shockie ads, which are similar to the ads that spawn during the first wave bosses, except now they have a little bit of a cutter beam around it. Just walk out of the beam and kite them as you did in the first three bosses. Now, once you kill the tank buster ad, this is the hard part. The boss will go into his intermission phase or second phase. One of the pylons will become active and you have to trigger it. Now, in order to do this, you would get to the pylon and you would actually channel on it. And once its energy bar reaches zero, the boss would become attackable. At the same time, though, the boss is casting Annihilation Ray, which if it finishes it, believe it or not, you get annihilated in one shot, going through immunities, by the way. Even if you could immune it, doesn't matter, though, because the boss would be immune to damage, right? So, and oh, by the way, I guess I should mention, if you hit any of the lights along the way, you'll get teleported back. Same thing if you walk into the bots, you'll get teleported back. If you stand on the parts that are on the ground that will light up, you will be stunned for a short period of time. Essentially, if you get hit by any of these guys, you might as well wipe because you'll run out of time. So here is what you have to do. First of all, you're going to want to go to the northernmost pylon, which is the one I'm standing at. Southern might be possible, but I had very little success with it. Basically, zero success with it. I was only able to do this on the northern pylon. Tank the tank buster ad there, and the second the tank buster ad dies, immediately get to the top of the platform. What I did was I double fell rush and even used my metamorphosis leap to get up there as soon as possible and immediately start clicking on the channel. Now, once you're at the top part, you're gonna have the two robots walking around you, which again, if you get hit by, you will be teleported back and it's a wipe. Or if you stand on the lit up parts and you get stunned, you're, again, it's pretty much a wipe because you, again, this guy's is going to come down to the millisecond. So keep channeling as long as possible. Now, when the robot gets close to you, as soon as it does, wait for the stun thing to go off. Walk around it to your left so you have more channel time, exactly like it did in the video. Again, this will allow you to channel longer onto the pylon. Now, once, guys, this came down to the very last second. I'm pretty sure the boss technically finished casting his Annihilation Ray, but I managed to get the channel down to zero, and then the boss will be stunned. He will take 100% increased damage. So if you can, try and save as many cooldowns as possible. Obviously, I didn't have my Metamorphosis Sleep, but I was still able to kill him, especially because I was using the Heart of Azeroth necklace. If you do not kill him, though, it's not the end of the world yet. You'll just have to go through another intermission phase, which, again, is the hardest part. I'm pretty sure I said again at least 10 times. Anyways, not the point. Once again, fucking hell. Anyways, most classes are not going to be able to do this, guys. Demon Hunter obviously can because of Meta Leap. Warriors, I actually do believe, might be doable. Let me know in the comments below with the, I think it's, what, a Double Leap or Triple Leap Legendary with Bounding Stride. You might be able to do it with that class. Monk and Warlock teleports might work. Let me know in the comments down below if it works for you guys, or honestly any other classes that you guys are able to do this on. But guys, most classes are not going to be able to do this. I'm telling you right now, you probably want to get an alt decently item level in order to do this. So with the fourth boss dead, to be honest guys, that is the hardest part of the whole hard mode. The rest of the dungeon is a joke. So let's move on to the Tussle Tonks. If you're not sure how it works, you're going to pull the Platinum Pummeler to the hammer. You have to get hit by three hammers to remove the damage reduction buff on it, and then you can kill the bosses. There really is not too much else to note about that. They really don't do anything else that's really dangerous. Just remove the sacks from the Platinum Pummeler, and then you'll move on from there for Tussle Tonks. Nothing hard mode there. Next boss is going to be KUJO, the robotic dog. Now, before you actually pull KUJO, you're going to turn to your left, and there's going to be a little pile of dog crap on the ground. click the dog crap, it's going to throw it into the furnace, activating the hard mode, and you can go ahead and pull KUJO. Now, the hard mode for this is that you'll basically get at some point in the fight, you will get a permanent 80% movement speed reduction on you. Now, obviously, if this were current, that'd be an issue, but right now, guys, the only thing to worry about is the flame vent, which you would have to LOS. But since you're doing this at 60, most of the times flame vent won't even hit you, effectively making the movement speed decrease irrelevant. So essentially, guys, throw the crap in the furnace and then kill the boss. It's really just that simple. So once you kill KUJO and also get past the security robots of detecting bad players, you're going to get to the head machinist from the machinist garden. And essentially, guys, once again, he's just you go in there, slap the boss with your baby maker, kill him. He really doesn't do anything. Kill the ads if you want and avoid the swirlies. Also the lines of fire. Not that big of a deal. Just go in there, one shot him, easy enough. After that, you'll finally head to the last boss, which is King Mechagon. Now, if you're not sure how his hard mode works, you would push that big red button in his room, and after a very short period of time, if you don't put in the correct activation sequence, which requires four people, you'll just instantly get one shot. However, there is a cheese that lets you solo this. So what you're gonna do is go ahead and pull King Mechagon in his aerial unit and reset him. Just pull him out of the room and reset him. Now the button you'll see will go down into the ground. Now go ahead and stand where he spawns, and the second he respawns, you need to pull him. So be right clicking, be casting abilities, pull him instantly. And if you pull him quickly enough, the button, it'll look like it goes down to the ground, but then it will instantly reappear, allowing you to push the button in the fight. So from there, you're going to do the fight as normal, and he has two phases. The first phase is when he's in his aerial unit. The only thing to really mention, I mean, don't stand in the blue balls on the ground and the blue swirlies, right? The Giga's app will just do some damage, nothing you can do about that, ignore it. Eventually, the boss will take off and fly in the air, and we'll do a cutter beam. Now, you can stand in it and do damage. Obviously, if you're taking too much damage from it, just simply move out of it. The first phase is easy. Once you kill off the unit, he'll stun you, which, by the way, on the hard mode, this is where you will wipe no matter what, because you get stunned, right? If you're doing this the normal way, that is, not the cheese way. He will go into the Omega Buster, which is his second phase. Now, again, this is pretty easy. He'll do the Giga Zap, just avoid the swirlies on the ground. You can get knocked off the platform, by the way, so do not. And it'll also just suck you into with the magnetic ability. So go ahead and just keep killing the boss until you get him to around 10%, 5% HP. Once you do that, get away from him, click the red button, kill off the Omega Buster, King Mechagon will pop out, and then you could kill him off, allowing you to solo hard mode Mechagon, giving you the keep DPSing and nobody explodes achievement, and also the aerial, the mount, the 100% drop chance mount. Now, I already have the achievement on my Demon Hunter. Now, in order to show you that this does work, I did go over on my DK with one of my guildmates. It is soloable still, but obviously I did it with a guildmate just because my DK was super undergeared. And also, my guildmate still needed the mount from the dungeon. And we did it. We did the cheese strat, and we got the achievement. And also, good job, Reese. Congratulations, he got the mount. So, it is still working. Now, I'm going to be honest with you guys, I thought about not making this video because I was afraid Blizzard would ban for it. But to be honest with you guys, I did more research on this. By the way, I was told about this in a comment on YouTube. You know who you are. Thanks for that. I did more research on this before I made this video. This has been in here, as far as I could tell, this cheese, since Mechagon came out in 8.2. So Blizzard has not fixed it at this point, so I just figured, screw it, let's make the video. We'll put it out there. It's not that big of a cheese anyways. It's old content. Who cares? So that's it. Just to reiterate, guys, pull the boss, reset him. The second he respawns, pull him. The button should reappear. Get the boss to 10 to 5% in phase 2. You click the button again. You kill him off. You'll get the achievement, and you should get the mount. There you go. Hard mode Mechagon done. And that's pretty much it, guys. Now, before I go, I do want to talk about the mount one more time. As far as I could tell, it is a 100% drop chance. Now, there is a possibility it works like Nightbane, where it's a 20% increased chance per player in your group. So again, when I did it with, for example, my guildmate Reese, it would have been a 40% drop chance if that was the case. And maybe he just got lucky and got the mount. However, I do think it is a just 100% flat drop chance if you complete this on hard mode, which, by the way, if you do with a friend who already has the mount, he will not get it, you will. So if you have friends, guys, it'll make the fourth boss, like one extra player will make the fourth boss so much easier, like infinitely easier. So if you have friends, obviously, as usual, I recommend doing it with friends, but it is possible to solo hard mode Mechagon, which I didn't think was a thing. So if you guys have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below. I was, as usual, do my best to answer it. If the guide helped you, please throw it a like. Sub to the channel if you are not, if you enjoy the content. And as usual, guys, I'm gonna ask you this time. Which Halo was the best Halo? What, do you think I actually trust you guys to answer correctly? No, it's Halo 3. Halo 3 is the best Halo. Until next time, guys. Bye-bye.